Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we ask that you please rise and kindly remove any caps as we get set to honor America and the great state of Hawaii with the singing of our national anthem and Hawaii Pono'i. Joining us tonight is a high school division grand champion of Brown Bags to Stardom, a title this person has won just last summer. Also a senior at St. Andrew's Priory, she excels in Shakespearean acting and is an accomplished celloist, but she aspires to be a pediatrician, making her 10th appearance here tonight at the Stan Sheriff Center. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Krista Chang.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free, and the home of the brave.
Ladies and gentlemen, Krista Chang.
Aloha basketball fans, and welcome to the Stan Sheriff Center for tonight's Big West Conference game between the UC Santa Barbara Gauchos and your Hawaii Rainbow Warriors. Here is your starting lineup. For the Gauchos, at forward, a 6'10 junior from Kelowna, British Columbia, number 12, Alex Hart. At forward, a 6'7 sophomore from Los Angeles, California, number 10, Maxwell Kupchak. At guard, a 6'5 freshman from Ladera Heights, California, number 3, Clifton Powell. At guard, a 6'3 junior from Stockton, California, number 2, Gabe Vincent. And at guard, a 6-foot senior from Hawthorne, California, number 1, Eric Childress. The head coach for the Gauchos is Bob Williams.
I ain't about to miss this opportunity. I'm about to give everything I got.
Let's go!
Forward, a 6'7 senior from Pacific Grove, California, number 32, Noah Allen. And forward, a 6'8 junior from Centerville, Utah, number 21, Gibson Johnson. Forward, a 6'8 sophomore from Melbourne, Australia, number 12, Jack Purchase. At guard, a 6'2 freshman from Los Angeles, California, Zero Leland Green. And at guard, a 5'9 sophomore from Dallas, Texas, number 2, Brock Steptoe. The head coach for the Rainbow Warriors is Aaron Gannon.
You're watching OC Sports, your home for University of Hawaii sports.
Been a season of ups and downs, moments of elation and incomprehension where the only constant is inconsistency. But in the Big West, once the ball is tipped, it's anybody's game. And tonight, Hawaii must rebound from a tough loss to take on a Santa Barbara team that has lost 6 of 7. The Gauchos are reeling, and the Rainbow Warriors need to get real. Call it a must win, call it a must watch. Stan Sheriff Center, the Hawaiian Tell FCU starting lineup scrolling in the bottom right corner of your screen. UC Santa Barbara comes in 3-15 on the year, 1-5 in the Big West Conference. They're riding a 3-game losing streak. Hawaii, they've lost their last two. They're 8-11 overall, 2-4 in the league. Hawaii wearing the all greens on its home floor. And Gibson Johnson wins the tip. This is a UCSB team that has been in a world of literal and figurative hurt as Leland Green tries to get the scoring started for Hawaii. Rebound off to Alex Hart. But Santa Barbara losing 4 players over the course of this season, 3 of them to academic issues, and they are thus ineligible for the rest of the season. That includes forward Jalen Canty, who was their second leading scorer. They also have a player out due to injury, and so they're forced to play a host of walk-ons. And as you see the foul committed out on the perimeter, Gibson Johnson picks up his first personal, trying to step out against Gabe Vincent.
Well, when the Hawaii bigs show so far out on the floor, to me it's a wasted foul to get called for a foul way out there. It's a non-factor. The guy's not doing anything. I don't know why they show so hard and pick up fouls that high.
Here's Eric Childress, hands it off to Vincent, and he gets fouled in the act by Leland Green. Gabe Vincent, a 6'3 junior from Stockton, California, one of the better scorers that this conference has to offer, averaging 15 points per game, shooting 35% from the field, and he's going to go to the free throw line where he has attempted and made more free throws than anybody else on this Gaucho squad.
Three shots.
We talk about the personnel issues, though, Artie. UC Santa Barbara coming off of a loss to CSUN, 78-57 in the Thunderdome on Wednesday. They were forced to play six players who walked onto this program. One of them, Maxwell Kupchak, one of the starters wearing number 10, he received a scholarship in the offseason, so he is no longer considered a walk-on. Well, five of them still are.
Yeah. You know, it's tough. It's tough on this program this year. And Kupchak's dad has enough money, he can probably fund his own college tuition. My goodness, he got a scholarship like he needed it. I mean, not that he didn't deserve it, earn it. I mean, I'm just saying, it's not need-based.
The cut by Noah Allen, nice little two-man game exhibited the time, courtesy Gibson-Johnson. Noah Allen averaging a team-high 12.9 points per game, also leading the team with 5.5 rebounds per outing and 9 steals on the season, as Gabe Vincent showing some of the versatility, this time going to the hoop.
Well, he split the big man when they tried to show. He just split the two-man game and just took it to the basket. Santa Barbara in that zone trying to save fouls. Of course, the Rainbow Warriors turned the ball over as Gibson Johnson and Noah misconnected.
So UCSB controls. Here's Eric Childress, the lone senior on the squad. Now the drop by Clifton Powell Jr. He is a freshman, and he gets the and one. The blocking foul is going to go against Jack Purchase. And how about this start by this shorthanded Gaucho squad?
Well, Santa Barbara, they are a team that has had a lot of problems, but at some point in time, they're going to have a nice ball game.
So Powell to the line. He started the last. Now 6 games for UCSB. Can't complete the 3-point play. But a guy who is getting more minutes by virtue of all the players who are not available, and then gets the poke away steal. Off and running, it's Powell. Tried to leave it for Vincent. And it's a turnover of an unforced variety.
Wow. Mark Steptoe got back and created a little defensive pressure.
That was a 3-on-1.
And you got to complete those plays. I mean, if you're Santa Barbara, you're missing free throws. You're blowing 3-on-1 opportunities. You wonder why they are struggling.
Purchase mid-ranger. One off the heel. And the rebound to Maxwell Kupchak. 6'7 sophomore from L.A. As Artie Wilson alluded to, he is the son of L.A. Lakers general manager Mitch Kupchak. Being harassed by Allen. 10 seconds to shoot here on this possession for the Gauchos. Crossover move by Childress, and a reach-in foul is going to go against Brock Steptoe. He got shook on that occasion.
Yes, he did.
And so Sharif Drame comes into the game, but check out that crossover action.
Drame comes in the ball game as,
oh boy,
Santa Barbara executes an inbounds play. It's like Rainbow Warriors look like they hadn't seen that before.
The 6'10 junior from Kelowna, British Columbia, Alex Hart, throws it down with one hand, but Noah Allen, the quick response.
And Noah Allen looks very fluid and smooth in this ball game.
Right now, UC Santa Barbara 7, Noah Allen 4. Here a little over 3 minutes in. You see the patience of the Gauchos. That one bounced off the foot of Johnson. And so able to retrieve it in the backcourt is Gabe Vincent. Now rubbing off the screen, tries to split the defense, and a foul is called. Who's going to pick it up? It's going to go against Jermaine, and he's wide-eyed about it.
Yeah, play a moment ago, an inbounds play. As you can see the camera from behind the basket, Gibson Johnson, 21 there, you see him get, he's looking to help out on the outside, realizing that the back door is wide open. A nice cut by the Santa Barbara big to get that basket. Good execution of their out-of-bounds play.
Guido Fleischer on the floor, comes in for Johnson. And they're going to wave that bucket off. It's going to be a travel against Alex Hart. Had good post position, but he shuffled the feet.
Yeah, and Alex Hart, that was a player that scored against Gibson Johnson on the inbounds play, but he also is showing the ability to catch and finish. So he looks good down low.
UCSB in a zone defensive look. Green for three from the corner. He is loving those corner balls.
He loves the corner on that side of the floor. He is on fire from that side of the floor and shoots it with an absolute amount of confidence.
He's averaging 12 and a half points per game in conference play, but right back at you, says Gabe Vincent.
Oh, Gabe Vincent says, Leland, I got something for you as well.
Vincent, the 28th Gaucho to surpass 1,000 career points. Allen misses on the turnaround jumper, and a foul on the rebound goes against Vincent for UCSB. Timeout on the floor. The Gauchos in front early on.
Bank of Hawaii, Kaiser Permanente,
a look at the Kaiser Permanente keys to the game. Artie, what you got?
Well, for Santa Barbara, they've got to have a change of mindset. In other words, they have to forget that they've been losing. Losing is such a habit-forming thought. You've got to change your mind. You've got to decide you want to win and do it. And for the Rainbow Warriors, quick, efficient, and finish. They've got to get out to a quick start, be efficient throughout the ball game, and finish the game.
So Hawaii controlling out of the timeout. Sharif Jermay running the point. Just trying to get it in low to Allen. Poked away and saved by Gabe Vincent. That's a heck of a play.
That's a great defensive play and great effort. Those loose ball plays, those 50-50 plays. When you're a struggling ball club, you need to make all of those.
Here's Powell. Leaves it along the baseline for the freshly inserted J.D. Slatcher. He's one of the walk-ons, one of the five that has seen action here as of late. Step back three by Childress. And Allen taking the elevator an extra floor to grab that rebound. Almost lost control. Finds a wide open Green for three.
Leland is saying, I'm becoming more comfortable with this side as well. Good shot by Leland Green.
It's the color of money, right? Yeah. Green strikes again. And we're tied at 10. And we got an offensive foul. It's going to go against Vincent. A little shoulder shiver against Sharif Jermay.
Let's watch it now. Watch the right shoulder, right arm, or the left arm.
And that's Vincent's second foul.
Yeah, it's a hip. Well, they don't have a lot of people to go to.
Oh, so
you got to feel for Bob Williams. I mean, Bob Williams has had a stellar career as coach at Santa Barbara, and I mean, I don't think he's ever had a season like this.
He is the elder statesman of this conference. It's 19th season for Bob Williams. One win from 500 for his coaching career. That includes his time at UC Santa Barbara. Also UC Davis back in their D2 days and Menlo College. The three by Purchase off the mark. Offensive board, Fleischer misses and follows it up. So Ito comes in place of starter Gibson Johnson. Gets the follow-up to give the Rainbow Warriors the two-point advantage. Pulled up by Powell. Fleischer fighting for the rebound, and he snags that one at the defensive end. Jermaine losing control of the dribble.
I'm not sure where Sharif Jermaine was going with that.
Yeah, the odds were not in his favor on that sequence. Slatcher forces up a shot, and it's going to be a foul on Alex Hart going over the back of Sharif Jermaine. Now take a look at Tyler Jackson. He's a 7'2", 284-pound freshman, also a walk-on from Naperville, Illinois.
How do they get the 7'2 walk-on and we get the 5'9", 5'10", 5'11 walk-ons?
Another turnover there as Allen was trying to sneak it down to Ito.
That's a big boy. I mean, you know, you said 285?
Yep. This is his third appearance this season for the Gauchos. Had 8.7 rebounds in 14 minutes in the loss the other night to CISA. But you can't coach size like that.
He's huge. And what a turnover there.
That was Max Heidegger.
Heidegger just dribbled it off his foot.
And now Allen along the baseline. Skip pass goes to Jermaine. Almost walked with it. Still plenty of time here on the shot clock. Jermaine tears to the hoop and finishes the deal. A 7-0 run here over the last 2+ for the Rainbow Warriors. They lead by 4, and Gabe Vincent, top scorer for the Gauchos, sitting with 2 fouls. Foot on the line, off the mark. Green collects the board. Down low, it's Fleischer. Muscle shot is good. And Ito is above his average with 4 points here tonight.
And Bob Williams is telling his team, slow it down now. We don't want to get in a track meet with this team. Pace and tempo has got to be in our favor if we're going to compete.
A 9-0 run for the Rainbow Warriors.
If you're Hawaii, you pick it up defensively. Now you've got them really, you want to put a lot of pressure on. You don't want to give them uncontested shots.
Heidegger, though, strikes from the outside, averaging 7 a game. Just a 19% three-point shooter, so a rarity to see that one go down. But they needed that bucket. Ended what was also a 14-3 tilt in favor of the Rainbow Warriors as Allen smooches it off the window. He's got 6.
Yeah, Noah looks good. I think more guys should hit that mid-range jumper off of the glass because it's a very effective shot.
Yeah, just ask Tim Duncan, made a Hall of Fame career out of that shot.
Played 20 years worth.
Poke away by Green, retrieved by Childress, but under 10 to shoot. Good defense by Green. Childress lets the 3 fly off the front iron. Tap to Jermaine. Fleischer active underneath the glass. Allen steps into a triple. And Powell able to corral it. Thoughts on the pace here so far?
Well, the pace is starting to become what Hawaii wants, and clearly not what Santa Barbara wants. They want to slow this thing down, keep it a slower ball game, be deliberate. Try and get something out of each and every possession and not have anybody scoring bunches.
And have Fleischer committing the foul about 26 feet out in front of the rim. Timeout on the floor, but Ito putting in work on the interior. Fleischer, Hawaii by 5. Welcome back. Series record sponsored by Aston Hotels and Resorts. UCSB leading the all-time series 8-6, but Hawaii has won the last three meetings. The last one came in the Big West Conference Tournament semifinals last year. Hawaii winning that one 88-76 behind a team-high 24 points by Stefan Jankovic. As you take a look at the sneaks being exhibited by the UH coaches, UCSB sporting some sneaks on the other side as well. That is part of an annual campaign to raise awareness for cancer. Yes, the National Coaches versus Cancer Week. National Basketball Coaches Association encouraging some of that awareness to take place. Now, in most parts of the country, it's a little bit more contrasted because you have coaches who wear suits along the bench with the sneakers, but we don't have the suits over here. And we got an offensive foul called against Heidegger. Another turnover here for UC Santa Barbara. Officiating crew tonight, by the way, Tom Nally, Andy Cohn, and Jeremy Denti.
A good cause, the sneakers. We all have been affected, and we all need to just continue to work toward finding that cure.
Yeah, it is a nasty, ugly, evil thing, and good to always call further awareness to it. And now, Zygmars Rymo calling further awareness to his game as he goes up and in and one. Foul called on the seven-footer, Tyler Jackson.
That was a case where two guys, neither one of them jumped. The offensive player didn't jump and the defensive player didn't jump.
Rymo to complete the three-point play. That one hit glass first. And Christian Terrell, 6'5 freshman from Sacramento, able to gather the board. Well, when you're 7'2",
you don't have to do a lot of jumping.
So you have to jump.
I've not seen that before.
Gabe Vincent back in the ballgame for the Gauchos, misses the short jump hook, gets his own board, and they'll reset with a fresh 30. Vincent all the way back near midcourt. The crowd applauding the defensive effort so far. Vincent turns the corner against Jermaine. It'll be a three by Terrell. That one long. Rebound off to Allen. Hawaii doing a good job boxing out underneath the defensive glass so far. Steptoe got blocked. Gathered by Johnson. He gets rejected. The first block was by Jackson. The second one was by Kupchak.
The bank closed.
Closing in on 8 minutes to play in this opening half. 13-3 run for Hawaii over the last 6 minutes plus, and UCSB compounding it. They're one of their last eight from the field, make it one of their last nine, and that didn't even hit the rim. Timeout on the floor. Hawaii out in front by seven. 7:55 to go in the first.
Rainbow Warrior Basketball on OC Sports is sponsored by Strong and Hawaii Honda Dealers.
Welcome back to the Stan Sheriff Center. Kanoa Leahy, Artie Wilson here courtside. It's a 20-13 advantage for the Rainbow Warriors. And we were talking about it earlier in the half, Artie. You got a feel for Bob Williams, 19th season as head coach for the Gauchos, the longest tenured Division I head coach west of the Mississippi, winning his coaching program history. And this is a UCSB program that has at times been a standard setter in the Big West. But this is just one of those outlier type of years where they seem to be snake-bitten with injuries, academic ineligibilities. And he's just trying to get to the finish line.
Yeah, he's just trying to get through it. I tell you, this requires all your coaching ability as a nice dish and finish. But this requires every motivational speech you have to try and change the fortunes. And it's difficult. I say it all the time. Winning is a habit-forming thing, and losing can be really habit-forming.
Rimo heads to the bench for Hawaii, and they will inbound. And poke away. Bad pass by Purchase, taken up the floor by Kupchak. Heidegger has a mishandle.
Says, what's wrong with that? I had my hand on top of the ball. He gets his arm hit by Jack Purchase, and he does have his hand on top of the ball. It's one of those.
It looks funny, and
if it looks funny, referees don't call it.
Well, he did that sort of nifty behind the back dribble. So for a second there, it was Steph Curry like, and then at the end, it was more Chicken Curry like.
Yeah. Ooh, that sounds real good.
Jermaine drew the contact and he'll go to the free throw line. That's another thing that he's able to do pretty efficiently is draw contact, and he gets the benefit of the calls many a times. And he's a 78% free throw shooter. Second foul on Alex Hart, who just checked back into the game. And so Jermaine goes to the line, had 11 points, 3 assists, and 26 minutes in the loss on Wednesday to UC Riverside. But coming off of the bench for the third straight game seems to be a role that he has taken to well here over the last few ball games.
I think it's a role that he has done well in. He's better coming off the bench at as the starter, as the point guard, as the guy to try and get it going. He was struggling with that, just turning the ball over without there being a lot of pressure. And now he's starting to play a little bit more like the Sharif Jermaine that played last year.
Here's Vincent circling at the top. And it's going to be a defensive foul called against Brock Steptoe. And that's going to be his second personal. Hawaii hedging those screens in a big way at the top.
They're hedging them way outside.
And we got Noah Allen coming back in for Steptoe, so he'll sit with that second foul, which assumably puts Sharif Jermaine back in the point guard position. Noah Allen had the hot hand for three games. I mean, how incredible was he, averaging 27 points? In those three games against Long Beach State, CSUN, and UC Davis, two of those wins. Got into some early foul trouble. In fact, fouled out against UC Riverside, was limited to just 8 points in 23 minutes. But when he has been on, he has been spectacular.
Yeah, he's been very, very good. And because there's such a difference in his abilities than a lot of other guys, when he's not been on, it seemed to be magnified.
Yep. 5 seconds to shoot. Green, step back three. A little long on that one. Allen bats it out to midcourt. Chased down by Heidegger. Heidegger draws the contact, and he'll go to the free throw line. Boy, he is a battery with legs.
Well, Heidegger is, he does not lack confidence. Let's just say that, in his abilities in his game. I'm not sure if his skill set is quite what he thinks it is, but he is aggressive to the basket. He's confident, taking it hard. Goes to the free throw line, knocks down the front end. We'll get the next one.
He now has 6 points, coming off a 12-point showing versus CSUN. Was his first double-figure scoring game since late December. 6'2 freshman from Malibu, California, out of Oaks Christian High School. He is said to be fluent in German. And he sticks the second free throw. And you look up at the scoreboard, and even though you have the sense that Hawaii has been more or less cruising in this one, they're only up three.
Well, the tempo and the pace of the game has started to be what Santa Barbara wanted. They wanted to slow things down.
It's an air ball from about 14 feet.
Should have been a 15-foot shot, and it was a 14-foot shot. Sharif Dermay. Mid-range game. He's an adjustment.
Well, if the Gauchos are to be competitive, being that they are so perimeter-oriented now, and that's certainly not a strength of theirs, just 27% from outside the arc this season, they're going to have to muck it up. They're going to have to make it a messy type of battle, as a traveling violation is called against Christian Terrell.
And Christian Terrell is a freshman, again, out of Sacramento, California. They've got a lot of puppies playing, and a lot of guys are just walking on to try and be a part of the program.
Hawaii shooting 45% from the floor, 42.9 for UCSB, but those are the kind of buckets that can raise the percentage when you get them up close and personal like that. The drop-off by Gibson Johnson to Sharif Dermay. Back to five here. How about the pass by Heidegger to a wide open Kupchak? That was pretty sweet.
Well, Heidegger goes to the floor. Like I said, I think he has great confidence in his ability.
Now Allen from straight on drops the triple. He's got nine.
He stepped into that shot with absolute confidence. Nice to see Noah. Knocked out a long-range shot.
Entering tonight, 10th in the Big West Conference in scoring average. Averaging 22.3 points per game over the last four. Vincent trying to respond, and he does. That was pretty.
Somebody's got to introduce themselves. On the defensive end, Gabe knocks it down from deep.
So he has nine to match Allen. Allen jumps ahead with his 10th and 11th points of the game. We got a little battle with a couple of the top scorers in the conference. Mm-hmm. Cutting to the bucket, that's Alex Hart. Almost lost it out of bounds, but able to save it to Heidegger. Leland Green laying out for that one. Heidegger again able to retain possession, 7 seconds to shoot. Vincent gets the step, goes to the hoop, wanted the call, no whistle. And Allen trying to send it ahead, it gets deflected by Terrell. Sloppy back and forth action, Terrell's layup no good. Jack Purchase rips down the rebound, and Terrell commits the ill-advised foul. So timeout on the floor. Coaches are trying to restore some order here. Welcome back. Let's check out how it works, presented by Central Pacific Bank. Artie.
And it starts with Gibson, but Johnson with the basketball. He gets the ball. Hawaii runs kind of a stack where one guy picks for the other. You see Sharif Dermay picking for Noah Allen. Noah Allen is there, and both defenders are looking at Noah Allen, realize he's the scorer. They both go to him, and Sharif just slides to the basket. Nice assist by Gibson Johnson, recognizing that two defenders went with Noah, and he had an easy dime that he dropped off to Sharif Dermay.
11 points for Noah Allen to lead all scorers. Gabe Vincent Hyman for UC Santa Barbara. He has 9. And out of the break, it is Jack Purchase shooting the bonus, 1-1. And he misses the front end. And Jack Purchase, that's just his third miss from the free throw line this season. He had made 30 out of 32 and has even made 15 in a row prior to that miss. Cup check. Stuck in the air, drops it off to Childress. Childress got that one spanked out of bounds by Ido Fleischer.
Ido Fleischer got a block. Good job by the young freshman. Ido said, no, 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 no. Ido.
More like E don't on don't. That shot.
Yeah, there you go. Ido said, no.
See, Tide Osefeso into the game for UC Santa Barbara. 5'10 sophomore, Rancho Cucamonga, California. Childress, the runner off the glass, too hard, dribbled out. Last touched out of bounds by Slatcher. And Hawaii takes over possession. 2:14 left to play in the first half.
The problem for Santa Barbara is if Gabe Vincent doesn't score, then they are struggling to get someone to score.
Allen turnaround shot. He got hit on the arm as he let that one release. And he'll go to the free throw line. Powell picks up the foul. So Noah Allen to the line, where he is a 76% free throw shooter. 6'7 junior, the graduate transfer from UCLA. It has been a season of peaks and valleys for sure, as Noah Allen has had to adjust to going from a role player type of position with UCLA under head coach Steve Alford to a go-to player here with Aron Ganot. But as we mentioned, he has accepted that, and when he has had it flowing, it's been a thing of beauty.
It's been special, and he is clearly the most complete player on the Rainbow roster. He just has had some ball games where he wasn't sure what his role and function was supposed to be, and he struggled a bit, but at the end of the day, he is still the most special player out there.
He might be on the way to one of those special performances tonight with already 13 points in Lewis Hart. And it's going to be a foul on Purchase. Number 12 fouls number 12, and it's number 2 on Purchase. So Hart to the free throw line. 53% free throw shooter. He didn't have his most memorable performance in the last outing, a loss to CSUN. Hart fouled out of that game in 11 minutes. Davis Rosittis left.
That's what I was going to say. We've had a player in the past.
Yes, Davis.
We could use Davis this year.
It was Davis who fouled out in the first half. Yeah. Of a game and left the game because he brought a certain energy. Left the game to a standing ovation. I don't think I've ever seen that. It might have been the first time in the history of basketball that a player fouled out in the first half and was cheered to a standing ovation. Allen getting fouled as he put it on the deck. He goes against Childress, his first. Eric Childress tops in the conference in steals, so he gets very handsy, and that time drew the whistle. And Allen again to the free throw line, where he is 2 for 2 tonight.
If you simply watch this ball game and you didn't watch the score, you would think that the Rainbow Warriors were dominating this game, and it's only a 6-point ball game.
Yeah, that's interesting.
You know, I mean, they seem like they've had total control. But, you know, up seven, I think Bob Williams would be pretty happy to say, hey, we go in the locker room, you know, less than 10. We're in striking distance.
Allen now with 15. And you're right, this last minute becomes pretty pivotal here as far as the momentum going into the break. Seconds to shoot, and that one deflected out of bounds. Last touch by Allen. So 6 seconds on the shot clock here for the Gauchos.
Another reminder that when Gabe Vincent is off the floor, they are struggling to find anybody that even really wants to shoot it or can shoot it.
Childress will try to shoot it. Misses it badly. Rebound caroms to Matt Owies. But his pass into the front court picked off by Powell. Ahead now to Osifeso. Jump to defend the rim by Ito Fleischer. Straight up the silo, so no foul called. And instead, it's Tide Osifeso who picks up the personal foul.
Ito says, no, little guy, stay out of here.
Using that rule, the law of verticality, when you're inside the restricted area, it is... the defender is better served to if jump. He jumps in the air.
But he's got to stay vertical.
Got to. At least the officials felt like Ito did, and he hits the free throw. So Ito Fleischer giving him some quality minutes here in this first half. Sharif Jermay checks back into the game, replacing Owens. Gets the friendly roll, does Fleischer on his second free throw attempt. So Ito now with 6 points, 5 boards in 10 first half minutes.
This has been one of his better ball games. Big possession for Santa Barbara. They need to score on this one to go in the locker room with some type of confidence.
15 seconds on the shot clock here. Three by Childress. Got it. Oh,
that's huge. That's huge.
A 30% three-point shooter cuts the deficit down to 6. Timeout Hawaii as they'll try to draw something up for the final 21-3.
Wow, that's a Chevy.
The most awarded lineup in the industry has people at a loss for words. Well, almost.
Wow, that's amazing.
Are you kidding me?
Wow.
This is
wow.
It.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
Wow. Wow.
Experience the wow factor. Take home an award-winning Chevy today.
Current qualified GM lessees can sign and drive this Chevy Cruze for around $176 a month. Plus, find your tag and get an additional $500 lease cash on select Chevy vehicles. See your Hawaii Chevy dealer.
Big Island Candies, the perfect place to find the perfect gift. Visit them at their flagship store in Hilo, at Ala Moana Center, or online at BigIslandCandies.com to see their amazing selection, including delicious chocolate dipped shortbreads.
Welcome back to the Stan Sheriff Center. So Ron Gannat talking to his team here prior to the final 21.3 of this first half. What would we be likely looking at here on this possession?
Well, I would hope that they would have something that they can get. The 21 seconds is plenty of time to get a good look. You want to get a shot opportunity and have an opportunity for a putback. And you got to look for Jack Purchase to be one of the guys because he can stand out there and shoot that three.
Jermay will control here. 10 seconds to go in this first half. Jermay finds Green on the other side. Step back. Shot is good. Foot on the line. It's a two-pointer. But Leland Green beating buzzers again.
Leland Green very, very confident in taking the basketball. Little crossover step back.
And Green is money again. He has 15 points for Noah Allen to lead the Bulls. Scott Robbs is with the Ron Gannat.
All right, thanks a lot, guys. Coach, you're up at the half. Feel pretty good about the way things are going so far?
I think we're playing better. We're playing more like a team. I didn't like how we defended coming out of the gates, but I thought we finished it off well. We got to take better care of the ball.
This is the second straight game where Jack Purchase has not scored in the first half. What do you do to try to get him involved in the second?
Well, he's got to continue to work harder to find gaps in the zone. And he does help us by spreading the floor. That's kind of the thing. I thought he did a good job getting some rebounds in traffic, and it'll come for him. Things open up for each other when other guys step up, too.
Thanks, Coach.
Thanks.
All right, Kanoa, back over to you.
Thanks a lot, Scott. Hawaii shoots 54% in the first half compared to 37% for UCSB. Still, it's a single-digit differential here. Rainbow Warriors lead 37-29. Halftime show coming up.
Halftime here in the Sheriff Center, where Hawaii holds an 8-point advantage over the Gauchos of UC Santa Barbara. Part of the reason why Hawaii is leading because of that young man right there, Noah Allen. After a not Noah Allen-like game a couple of days ago, he has turned it up here in the first half. 15 points on 5 of 7 shooting and a perfect 4 for 4 from the free throw line.
And you knew he was going to come out and be overly aggressive tonight and put this team on his back, as I said, and try to lead them to victory alone tonight. He's finding that little mid-range game right in the zone, and he's being aggressive. As soon as he catches, he's looking to score. Look for him to continue to be aggressive, and look for Santa Barbara to make an adjustment on him as well. But I don't think they have anybody who can guard Noah Allen on the perimeter.
You know, and he's getting it done all over the floor, like you talked about. Mid-range, he cutting through the basket. Teammates are doing a great job of finding him. He's finding the stroke from the three-point line, 1 out of 2 from three-point land. So you got to love that start from Noah Allen, 15 points already in the first half.
Well, I think the first half, that last shot by Leland Green, I think I said in the beginning of the season, hey, relax, give the kid a little time. He'll get better as the season goes on. You know, when a guy first moves to Hawaii and he starts to play for Hawaii, whether it's in one of the smaller schools or the university, it takes a while for him to get adjusted. Leland now has gotten adjusted. He's playing really good ball.
Yes, Leland Green is playing good ball. He's just in his groove right now. He's comfortable. He's playing loose. He's playing free. And he's having fun out there. And that's what you like to see as a freshman. And we're seeing him grow up and develop right in front of our eyes.
Oh, yeah, no question about it. But you're getting a lot of help from the big guys inside. And what a great freshman coming off the bench. Ito Fletcher just doing a nice job. Yes, we wanted him to throw that down with authority, but he stays with it and is able to come back on the defensive end and really makes his presence felt. And what no one else sees out here from Ito is he's running the floor exceptionally well when the ball is not in his hands. So I like what he's bringing to the table. He's hustling down court, and he's also staying out of foul trouble and being that disruptive force inside, picking up the first block shot that Hawaii has had in the first half in a long time. So hats off to the freshman coming off the bench.
All righty, we are at the half.
half, Hawaii and Santa Barbara. The Bulls with the lead. Maybe that guy will be on the team next year. All right, this is one of the reasons why I prefer slippers over shoes. This happens to me quite often. I can get one on, that second one, well, not so good. And I want to squash all rumors right now. Tony did not coach him in high school.
No, wait. When I do that, I'll tell you something right now. I sit down to put shoes on. I don't stand on one leg to put shoes on.
Well, then he couldn't stand up. It's a competition, right?
That's classic.
All right, guys, we're back. Hawaii's up at halftime, but as I mentioned to the coach, in the last two games, Jack Purchase has not scored in the first half. Granted, he has five assists in the first 20 minutes, but no points in 16 minutes, and only one rebound from Purchase. That's not going to get it done.
Yeah, that just shows you his level of aggressiveness. It doesn't seem like he's trying to force the issue, because he's actually getting the same looks that Noah Allen is getting in the high post in that zone, but he's not turning looking to score. He's just turning looking to be a reverse guy at the top of that zone. He just has to pick his level of aggressiveness up, and he needs to help Noah Allen in the scoring column.
Go ahead, Coach. We're gonna give you a chance to talk.
No, you know, I just think he has to. I agree with John. He's got to be a little more aggressive. You know, he's a great catch and shoot guy. I would match him shooting a 3-point shots before the game or at halftime of the game or during the game with anybody in the country if he's open. He does not, under any circumstances, take a bad shot. And I have never seen him drive to the basket yet this year.
You know, and the thing is with Jack Purchase is he's bringing a lot to the table, at least from passing standpoint. He's a great point forward on the top of the key. He led the way with all the assists from the Hawaii Warriors in that first half. But you like the looks that everyone is getting down low. Everyone's looking for each other. They're picking each other up, and you gotta love that team play from the Warriors. Everyone's getting involved, and they're finishing in the paint with the layup.
Absolutely, with 10 assists, that's what you love to see as a coach, and only 8 turnovers. You want to get that turnover number down. However, this team loves sharing the basketball, and it's continued to show up tonight where they have those 10 assists. But Jack Purchase, he does have 5 assists tonight in the game in the first half, but he has to pick it up on the offense and be a threat from that high post in that zone.
All right, Coach, Hawaii's up at the half. What do they need to maintain this lead, or at least come away with the W? What would you like to see?
Noah Allen.
That's it.
That man plays, we win.
I like to see Jack Burgess, of course, get involved. And you got to love the fact that he's looking for his teammates, but it's time for him to understand they're up 8 points. It's time for him to get a little bit more aggressive in the paint and find his stroke from the outside, but work inside out in the second half.
I would like to see them picking up the intensity on the defensive end. Right now, they only have one steal, no fast break points. Pick it up on the defensive end. Create some easy offensive transition opportunities to get some momentum swings and just play solid team defense. And maybe have those bigs not stretch out so far on that pick and roll defense where they're not picking up those cheap fouls 40 feet away from the basket.
And also on the defensive side, if Hawaii can contain Gabe Vincent, it looks like Hawaii should be able to come away with the W. All right, the four of us, we'll be back with this one's foul. There you see Rich Sheriff, the manager of the Stan Sheriff Center. He's looking for the three-point shot from Jack Burgess.
Rainbow Warrior Basketball on OC Sports is sponsored by Bank of Hawaii, Kaiser Permanente, and Island Air.
Welcome back to the Stan Sheriff Center, where your halftime score is Hawaii up 8, 37-29 on UC Santa Barbara. Time to take a look at McDonald's halftime stats. Artie, what do you see through some of these numbers?
Well, I see Santa Barbara is 9 out of 24 in the first half, and they're shooting 37%. Oh, I think we have it switched right there, but Santa Barbara's shooting 38%, Hawaii at 50%. Three-point goals, both teams have knocked down a few. Free throws are pretty even. Rebounds, Hawaii has the advantage. And right now, it's really Gabe Vincent and whoever else can try and find some scoring for Santa Barbara against the Rainbow Warriors. Noah Allen is playing effective. Leland Green has been effective. Gibson Johnson has dished the ball out pretty good. I agree with the corner crew. Jack Purchase has got to find his way to be a difference maker in this ballgame. He's got 5 assists, but you can't play 16 minutes and not score and get just one rebound. You've got to make your presence felt more in the ballgame.
He does have 5 assists, so you can say he's at least adjusting and seeing the defensive layout from that standpoint. But, yeah, you would like to see him more assertive under the glass. Well, even more so maybe than getting open for some of those long-distance
shots. Because he stays out at the perimeter, he's not going to get a lot of offensive rebounds because he's always outside. But on the defensive side, he can go in there and grab rebounds because he wants it. As we see a little guy here trying to win the contest.
Yeah, no, you,
and he's been working it.
You may have been hearing the crowd and how loud they were getting. It's because of that little dude.
That little dude was
keeping him entertained on the big screen on the scoreboard above.
Man.
Some Marty Wilson-like moves.
No. He was far surpassing what I could ever do. Well, Hawaii at up by 8 points, need to come out and just dominate the second half. And it would be nice to see for the Rainbow team, if they dominated, that there are a lot of the bench guys could get a few moments.
But as you pointed out, that first half had the feel as though Hawaii was never really forced to break that much of a sweat. And yet, it's just an 8-point differential here as we start half number two.
Well, the first 5 minutes is always critical in the second half of a ball game.
So same starting five for both sides with the exception of J.D. Slatcher right here with the basketball getting the start for UCSB here in the second half. Shot from out in front by Gabe Vincent. Falls into the hands of Noah Allen, and Hawaii will get into its first offensive possession of the second stanza.
How would you like to be Gabe Vincent and know that basically you have the green light whenever you want it?
They're getting a lot of double teams, even triple teams, with some of the guys that are missing not exactly creating room for him as Noah Allen finds room for himself right down Kalakaua Avenue.
And I like the assist by Brock Steptoe.
Steptoe, another guy who offensively has seen a bit of a dip in the numbers. Just 4 points, was 0 for 6 from the floor against UC Riverside. Has attempted just one shot so far tonight, got it blocked. Who's Childress? Kupchak with a hand in his face, gets fouled by Gibson Johnson. And for Johnson, that is personal foul number two.
Gibson's got to be a little smarter than that. That is a very difficult shot for Kupchak. Maxwell Kupchak.
He'll shoot too.
I'm not sure he's really a catch and dribble and pull up and shoot it guy.
He walked on to the program last year, made 17 starts last season, and thus received a scholarship prior to this year. You mentioned his dad, Lakers general manager Mitch Kupchak. So, of course, he roots for the home team Lakers. Also a Yankees fan, and also, I'm happy to report, a Detroit Lions fan. Not sure how that added up, but hey, Lion Nation will take all the support we can get.
Mm-hmm. This zone has been what the Gauchos have been trying to run the entire night.
Yeah, they've pretty much primarily been zoned up here against Hawaii, and they're able to take the ball away on that possession. This has also been a theme, very deliberate offensively, taking a lot of time off of the shot clock. They get down deep into it before they usually chuck one up. And here's Vincent with under 10 to shoot. Gets around Green. The layup falls off the iron, though.
Well, it's around the weave until Gabe Vincent gets the ball and then let him go one-on-one.
Gibson Johnson gets fouled. This looks like it will go against Slatcher. That's his first, and so Gibson Johnson to the line.
He's a walk-on as well, right?
Correct. He is a 6'6 sophomore from Oak Park, California. Actually, his third year with the program, redshirted 2 years ago. Didn't play last year because of an injury. But yes, one of now five current walk-ons in the rotation for UC Santa Barbara because of all the players that are out.
I'm still trying to figure out how Bob Williams gets 6'6", 6'7", 7'2 walk-ons. I mean, those are big, that's big bodies to go out there and just come walk on.
He may be, you know, in that part of California, he may be perusing the volleyball courts around town. Under 10 to shoot here. Childress again loses Steptoe, misses the point blank lane, and And Slatchard is fouled and followed. And this is going to go against Johnson. Johnson, none too pleased about the whistle. That's his third. And so Ito Fleischer gets queued up, gets ready to check in.
That's a tough call against Gibson Johnson.
Gibson Johnson, who we found out in the pregame, his dad, a professional golfer. Yeah,
he can play too.
He was an all-state golfer in high school, and the word is he's a scratch golfer, and I could see Johnny White's competitiveness
Johnny loves golf. If Johnny could play golf for a living, that's what Johnny would do.
Apparently, he's not too far away from being good enough to do so. He's saying he's shooting in the 70s on the reg.
Okay. I put my money on Johnny. Against the corner crew, anyway.
Johnny told me that. I said, are you breaking 80 on a regular basis? He said, yeah, I'm breaking 80. And right there ended any desire I ever had to play with Johnny White. Fleischer, couldn't haul in the pass from Purchase. Decent idea, but the execution wasn't there.
The play wasn't there. I mean, what Jack Purchase did was run the play the way it's designed, but if it's not there, you got to go to option B or C.
Powell. Good close out there by Allen. Fleischer trying to grab that rebound, but it's Leland Green that comes out of the scrum with it. Bounce pass to Purchase. Lets the three fly. Rims out. Fleischer the follower.
Ito Fleischer. Ito says, I like playing against this team.
Yeah, Ito's getting his groove on here. He's got 8 to go along with 6 rebounds. The foul about 25 feet in front of the rim.
It's showing so far out, I'm not sure.
That's his third, so he and Gibson Johnson with 3 fouls apiece. So cue Zygmars Raimo. But Fleischer receives a well-deserved ovation from the fans. Vincent goes cross court. Powell almost lost it. These are very disheveled possessions for the Gauchos. Case in point, as Raimo took it away, and then Vincent commits the takedown. Third foul on Vincent. It'll be 1st and 10 Hawaii on the other side of this break. Painful sequence right before the timeout for Zygmars Raimo. You see the collapse here on Gabe Vincent. Rymo coming away with a loose ball, and then Vincent, the tackle, the ball bounces into Rymo's face, and then he hits the deck. And it was kind of a tough all-around moment there for Zigmars as we take a look at the First Hawaiian Bank top three. Big West Conference individual steals leaders, Eric Childress of the Gauchos. He tops the list, 2 steals per game. Had a career-high 6 steals in that tournament semifinal loss last year to Hawaii. Purchase open for 3. Rims out on it. He's now 0-for-3 from out there tonight. Since his 25-point outburst against Long Beach State in the games following, he is now 5-of-18 from beyond the property line. So Jack Purchase trying to, once again, find that flow.
Well, Jack Purchase, I mean, that last shot was an excellent shot attempt, so he's got to continue just to shoot it.
Cup shot. Almost turns it over. In fact, does. Well, not so fast. Childress winds up with it somehow, and then all kinds of contact. The foul is called against the Rainbow Warriors. How would you describe this game here? What would be the adjective that most encompasses what we have seen so far?
Why would you ask me that question like that? It's kind of a frustrating basketball game.
You know, interesting.
It's frustrating because there's not been great execution. But the Rainbow Warriors are finding ways to get it done, and you have to credit them for that.
Vincent misses for 3.
You feel kind of bad for Bob Williams and his squad because he really has... I mean, it's like going to a battle with one gun. And every so often, he's got to reload. And when he doesn't have his gun drawn, they don't have much.
Green, hard drive along the baseline. Oh, it went deep down into the bucket, but somehow back out. Couldn't have gone any further down without counting. Yeah, Bob Williams, he's not used to this. I mean, in his 19 years, 14 winning seasons, 3 Big West Conference regular season titles, 3 Big West Conference tournament crowns. This year, just 3 wins, period. And as you see, the bucket by Slatcher.
Well, Slatcher had a nice putback. There was a drive that hit the side of the backboard.
Allen for 3, yes. Noah Allen, he's got 20. Defense there by Purchase, anticipating the lob. Allen sends it ahead to Drame. The runner hits nothing, and the rebound grabbed by Vincent. Slatcher. And it'll be a blocking foul called against Purchase. That's number 3 on him. So starting to see some of the Hawaii bigs adding up those fouls.
Jack Purchase comes over just a little late and doesn't square up and take that contact.
So Slatcher to the line. A self-described specialist in the history of the World Wars. Military history buff.
Okay.
And kind of buff.
He is general. Buffed. Yeah, he is buffed. We need those kind of walk-ons at the University of Hawaii. I mean, look at him. That's a big boy. That is a big young man.
Second free throw secured by Noah Allen. So Allen back in the mix here, Artie. 20 points, 7-of-9 from the field. He's hit all 4 of his free throws. He's also got 6 rebounds. Here he is underneath, gathering up in and 1.
Good assist by Zigmar.
And Drew Bugs doing some push-ups in celebration of that finish by Noah Allen. Kupchak picks up the foul, his first.
Noah Allen having fun in this ball game.
graduated with a degree in political science at UCLA. Pretty impressive just to be able to say that.
Yeah. Enough said.
Question. Where does the scoring come from, if not from Gabe Vincent, as that one is thrown away. Hawaii takes over, and now you're starting to see the Rainbow Warriors tightening the grips on this one as Bob Williams,
he sits
the
back.
Exemplification of frustration.
Yeah, he just, I mean, it's not that he's not coaching them, but he's just sitting back and just watching it a little bit now, and you know, he's done what he can do, trying to get them ready to go. And he's just being handicapped, so to speak, because he lost so many players.
Allen, the pull-up three. Oh, boy. Noah Allen has 26, and he surpasses 25 points for the third time. Make that the fourth time in the last five games. Noah's arc was pure for another triple.
Big Island Candies, the perfect place to find the perfect gift. Visit them at their flagship store in Hilo, at Ala Moana Center, or online at BigIslandCandies.com to see their amazing selection, including delicious chocolate-dipped shortbreads.
Noah Allen surpasses 25 points for the fourth time in the last five games. He's got 26, 9 of 11 from the field. It's been all good for Noah Allen tonight.
He's been very efficient, very comfortable. He's doing it from inside. He's doing it from outside. He's driving it. He's shooting it. Love to see him having success.
Vincent now controls for UCSB. So we have seen our fair share of Noah Allen brilliant performances like we are seeing transpire tonight. We've also seen some games where he hasn't been as involved and has, in fact, perhaps gone so far as to struggle. What do you think is the difference? Well, why on some nights is it there, some nights maybe not?
Sometimes it depends on who's guarding him, and if they're double-teaming him and keeping the ball out of his hands. UCSB doesn't have enough firepower to stop him defensively, and it makes it much easier on him.
Zygmar Zarimo with the jump hook. And Hawaii starting to really establish its authority in this second half. Rimo this time called for the reach-in foul. An 11-1 rainbow run. Timeout on the floor. 53-35 is the score. Rimo. 4 points to contribute to this 18-point advantage.
Thank you. the care your family needs. All connected for you.
Order envy. When you want what you have, and what they have, you can stop staring. The answer to order envy is here. Introducing the new Double Stack Tacos. Spicy sweet, nacho crunch, and cool habanero. It has everything you got with everything they got. Double Stack Tacos. Two flavors stacked together in one taco.
If someone is seriously injured, what does Levitt, Yamani, and Soldner do first?
First, we will go where we are needed. To the hospital if requested, whether it be in Hilo or Hanalei, or anywhere in between.
Then we put together the evidence so that we can prove how and why someone has been injured.
It's often not easy, but it's the only way to force the wrongdoers and their insurance companies to take full responsibility.
Levitt, Yamani, and Soldner. Call 537-2525.
Welcome back, taking a look at tonight's Jack Pack. Looking for a slump buster, Hawaii trying to avoid its first three-game regular season conference losing streak since dropping four straight when they were part of the Western Athletic Conference back in 2012. And so far, so good. Hawaii shooting 55% for the game, 60% in this second half. But it has been Noah Allen leading the charge, the lone player in this game in double figures. He's got 26 to go along with six boards. He also has an assist.
Well, Noah Allen is, you know, we've all said it, and I'll continue to say it, he's the best player on Hawaii's team. And they would be in a tough way without him. But, you know, the other person I want to compliment in tonight's ball game, Leland Green, because he has been the primary defender of Gabe Vincent, and he has made Gabe Vincent work really, really hard.
And the turnover by Jermaine. Vincent comes out of there with it. Sends it ahead to Kupchak. Meanwhile, UCSB, you just see how shorthanded they are. I mean, Bob Williams is trying to play Connect Four with only three game pieces. And there is Leland Green right on cue with the defensive play, able to poke it away from Heidegger.
Well, there's Bob Williams, and boy, I'd love to be in his mind right now. You think he's saying, oh yeah, you know, you pour it on right now. But next year, I get my pieces back. I got some, I'll remember who poured it on.
Jalen Canty, their second leading scorer, one of three players who midway through the season was deemed academically ineligible. So out for the rest of the year as Johnson gets fouled on the inbounds. Foul will go against Alex Hart, and that's number three on him. See the handsy defense of Alex Hart. Also, Jarice Blackman, he's a 6'7 sophomore, out with a fractured left elbow, was injured in the Big West Conference opener against UC Davis, out 4 to 6 weeks. So we're probably looking at another 2 to 3 weeks that he'll be missing in action. And so it's just one of those years. If you're Bob Williams, you didn't expect to have to make these kinds of personnel adjustments. And unfortunately, looks like they're on their way to seeing this losing streak continue. They've lost three straight. They started the year 0-5. Now 3-15 overall.
Well, the hard part is because they've lost so much, it's a familiar situation now.
Of course, it didn't help that they played one of the toughest non-conference schedules in the country. So, on top of everything else, Leland Green. The tip by Johnson, no, but a foul. Will this go against Vincent? It will, and that's number four on Gabe Vincent. With 10:22 left to play, Vincent will have to sit. 9 points, 3 of 9 from the floor. Leland Green has contributed in a big way to make things difficult for a very capable scorer in Gabe Vincent.
Yeah, Leland Green is learning how to play defensively.
really well at Division I basketball now. He initially was playing a lot with his hands. Now he's moving his feet much better. You see Gibson Johnson with that YMCA move.
Yeah, how about that footwork? Johnson now with five. Leland Green, I mean, he already has and came into this program out of Redondo Union High School. He already has that college physique. Yeah. For him, it was just a matter of getting adjusted to the speed of Division I college basketball.
He's going to have a nice career. Leland Green will improve and grow and get stronger, get better, get smarter as a player.
ESPN had him rated 30th in the state of California. And the free throw is good by Christian Terrell. Was Terrell's first point. Second one, no good. Terrell has now scored a total of 2 points in his last four-plus games. Steptoe. Little interior passing game, but Hart slapped that one off the glass. Heidegger. And a reach-in foul called against Sharif Jermaine. Now, if you're Aram Ganat, how closely are you sort of keeping an eye on things? You certainly don't want to tempt fate, leading by 21, 9:38 left. Gabe Vincent, top scorer for Santa Barbara, sitting on the bench for the time being with four fouls. How are you gauging your substitution patterns here in the rest of the way?
Well, I'm looking at Gibson Johnson walking off with that right arm, looking like he's hurt. I'd probably sit down Gibson Johnson. I think that's enough for him. I'd play with Ido Fleischer. And we haven't seen Larry Lewis Jr.
But Zygmunt Reimer with the bloody nose. You got Gibson Johnson with that arm, that shoulder injury that has been bugging him really the entirety of the year.
Ramos looks like he took a
look like they just came out of the UFC octagon.
Yeah, and he's smiling. That just tastes good. I mean, he's acting like it feels good. It tastes good. Okay, Zygma. This is where I like playing basketball. Like this. You know?
Nobody makes me bleed my own blood.
He's packing his own nose right over there now. All right, big fella. I like that. Jason Gould is like, I'm not touching you.
Allen gets fouled by Terrell, and he'll go to the free throw line to add to his point total. Second foul on Terrell. I'd like to take this time, since we have a little break in the action, to congratulate the latest class of inductees to the University of Hawaii Circle of Honor.
Absolutely.
Riley Wallace, of course, the winningest head coach in UH basketball history. Tony Davis, who was the first rainbow player to be drafted into the NBA. And how about Pops, Jim Leahy?
I think it's a great honor for your dad and all three of the gentlemen, but your dad especially has had a tremendous career, and he continues to work and do the job that he's always done. He does it very well.
Heidegger, pull-up shot, sends it a little long. And last touched out of bounds by the Gauchos. I know you like this class. It's a hoops-heavy induction class. Yeah,
no question. And I think, like I said, your dad is well-deserving. And I spent many a year with him and traveled many a trips with him. And there are a lot of stories that we could tell, but it's not for television.
Oh, boy. Please don't. Please do not go any further.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, we'll leave that alone.
The tip by Allen, not there. Osafiso sends it ahead to Heidegger. Doesn't get the roll. Here comes Leland Green out of the pack. Green, long strides to the bucket. Tip by Allen. What a play.
Noah Allen is just having a fun night.
Well, did they give that to Allen or Fleischer? It
no.
Most certainly looked like Allen was the one who tipped it in.
It's Allen. It wasn't Fleischer.
They announced Fleischer over the PA system here. Is that shot off the mark? think that that was a Noah Allen tip, so we'll see. Neil Iwamoto, Sports Information Director for Hawaii, might have to take a look into this.
Yeah.
Let's see if we can see it. This is the Fujitsu cool play of the game. The question is, was it Noah or Ito? Oh, it was Noah Allen.
It was Noah, without a doubt. Fleischer wasn't over the rim.
So that should actually be the 29th and 30th points of the game for Noah Allen.
Yeah.
At least according to the stats we have in front of us, Fleischer instead has 10. So we'll see if that gets flipped around. Because if it does, then Noah Allen has his second 30-point game of the season.
They've got to correct that because there was no question about that.
Yeah.
I mean, one guy was over the rim. One guy was still trying to get to the rim. Figure out which one was which.
And no offense to Ito.
To Ito.
I mean, 10 points by Ito would be a great story, but 30 points by Noah Allen is a little bit better.
Yeah. And then he shoots an air ball. Come on, Noah.
Come on, Noah.
We're over here talking about you. You shoot an air ball.
Foul by Heidegger. Fleischer picks up the foul. 61-38 domination by the men from Manoa.
Flying the Island Way just got upgraded. At Island Air, we've added to our fleet to better serve you. Say hello to our brand new Q400 turboprop aircraft. These planes are fast, 30% faster than conventional turboprops. And they're comfortable, with an advanced noise and vibration suppression system for a quieter, smoother flight. Come fly in our modern new Q400s. The latest way to fly... The Island Way with Island Air.
Want a real taste of New York? The Big New Yorker tempts you with freshly made dough rolled into 16 inches of foldable crust. It's handmade to perfection with a sweet marinara sauce and your favorite topping. And 30% larger than our large, the Big New Yorker is only $9.99 for one topping. Take your own selfie on Instagram to show how much you love the Big New Yorker. It's so close, you can taste it. Only $9.99 with one topping at your nearest Pizza Hut. Hawaii's best.
It's kickoff time at your Servco Toyota dealers. And you can go all the way in a 2017 Camry SE for only $21,695. Lease a 2017 Tacoma Double Cab SR5 V6 for zero down and only $273 a month. And score a 2017 Corolla with 0.9% APR. Kick off the new year in style. Rush to the kickoff to savings event. Happening now only at your Servco Toyota dealers.
Welcome back. The newest line of UH apparel and spirit items are now available at the H Zone stores at Ward Center and in the Stan Sheriff Center. All proceeds benefit UH teams and student athletes. You can also shop online at hzoneonline.com. Noah Allen, the story tonight for the Rainbow Warriors. 30 points, 10 of 13 from the field, hitting all seven of his free throws. The only player in this game in double-figure scoring.
And also, we got to talk about his 7 rebounds in the ball game, and he's got 30 points in taking only 13 shots.
That's efficient right there.
That is very efficient. That's KD-like. KD of this year.
Meanwhile, on the other side, UCSB shooting 26% from the floor. They've made just one field goal in the second half. They're 1 of 14 from the field. 7%. In the second half, they're also shooting 63% from the free throw line. They are, we hate to pile on them here, but they are dead last in 6 Big West Conference categories, including scoring, free throw percentage, field goal percentage, 3-point shooting percentage, as Purchase misses a 3. Ito Fleischer appears to have maybe tweaked something.
Yeah, he had like an ankle. It's almost like he had a blowout.
Also picks up a foul, but he was grimacing. That's his 5th foul, actually, so he will leave the game. Gibson Johnson comes back in, but Fleischer walking somewhat gingerly off to the side. Not sure what he did, but seemed like he made it. May have tweaked an ankle or knee or something along those lines. No field goals in the last 7 minutes and 13 seconds for UCSB. So, I mean, you're talking about...
That's a drought.
Well, California, unfortunately, has experienced some drought conditions here as of late.
The state well.
Yeah, UCSB experiencing a drought of its own in a huge way. Hawaii by 20. So for the Rainbow Warriors, a win would mean their fourth straight against the Gauchos. It would also mean that they would finish this five-game homestand with a 3-2 record. The two losses, difficult to swallow for sure. Close one against UC Davis. Close one against Riverside on Wednesday. But 3-2 over this five-game homestand, how would that measure, you think, Artie?
Well, for me, it would be disappointing, to be quite honest with you, because I think they should have gone 4-1 at worst. Because at home, you've got a whole serve, but I'm sure they'll take 3-2 because the alternative would be 2-3 and would be good.
Yeah. Heidegger contested three. Sails well long. They're now 1 of 15. 0 for 5 from outside the arc. Those numbers here in this second half.
This next 6:29 could take a little while. And if you're Coach Ron Gannat and the staff over on the Hawaii side, you've got to look down the bench and see a few guys who haven't seen a lot of playing time recently. It might be time to give some of those guys a moment or two just to make them feel a part of everything once again.
Steptoe to the line, and he gets his first point of this game. He's only attempted one field goal, but UCSB now with 7 team fouls. So Hawaii in the 1-1 bonus. They have 10 team fouls on their side, so the Gauchos actually in the two-shot bonus. So you're right. These whistles are going to put a pause into the action the rest of the way.
Well, Brock Steptoe was number 5 in the conference in free throw shooting at 82%. Now he's knocked down 2. That'll help him a bit.
That will help UCSB feel a bit better as Tide Osifeso, another walk-on, making his 12th appearance this season, sticks the triple. And that is their first made field goal in over 8 minutes. And Jack Purchase!
And credit Brock Steptoe for passing up a shot and finding Jack Purchase because he needed to see the bottom of the basket. Nice job by Brock Steptoe.
Yeah, he breaks the ice. Osifeso misses that one. Jack Purchase now 1 of 6, 1 of 5 from outside the three-point line. And he's got 3 points.
I would like to see the Rainbow Warriors find him once again on a jump shot.
Allen, that's a new season and career high for Noah Allen. He has 32 to go along with 8 boards, by the way.
Wow. And everyone's always concerned about Noah. People need to leave him alone.
Purchase grabbing the rebound. Second 30-point performance for Noah Allen. His fourth game out of the last 5 where he has surpassed 25 points. And it's a new season and career high, and he's about to get a chance to add to it. As you see a couple of subs checking into the game, Sharif Germain and Zygmars Reimel. Apparently the bleeding has ceased in the nose.
Well, he packed it. He packed that nose. You know, the finest pack, he did that.
Sam Walters, 6'2 sophomore, into the game for the first time here for UC Santa Barbara. You won't believe this, but he's a walk-on.
Oh, wow. I mean, they have another walk-on.
They got 5 of them. And they all play.
Noah, continuing to load up.
He's got 34. An epic performance by Noah Allen. And you're right, Artie, there were questions following just the 8-point output in the loss to UC Riverside. And you see the tough shot stuck by Kupchak. Noah Allen has answered some of those questions and then some.
Yes.
I mean, he is on an absolute tear here in this homestand. Steptoe for 3, doesn't get the bounce.
Well, what I like about what Noah Allen has done, not only is he scoring, but he got 8 rebounds. That's tremendous.
closing in on 4 minutes to play. Terrell gets fouled. Noah picking this one up. We'll take a break. Hawaii up big.
When it comes to your health, you want the best. Straub Medical Center is nationally recognized for quality, safety, and patient experience. And since it's part of the Hawaii Pacific Health Network, you get access to more specialty care. Experience the Straub difference with over 200 doctors at 15 locations, accepting more than 150 insurance plans. Because healthier is receiving quality care focused on you. Learn more at straubhealth.org.
Get ultra-fast internet from Oceanic Time Warner Cable for only $29.95 per month. Call 643-3333 now to get a free speed upgrade to 100 megs. Plus, get your first month free. So no matter if you're in town, in the country, or anywhere else across the islands, Oceanic gives you our fastest internet speed across the state. Call 643-3333 now to get a free speed upgrade to 100 megs and your first month free when you get Oceanic internet for only $29.95 per month. Get access to over 3,100 free Wi-Fi hotspots throughout Hawaii. Oceanic gives you all the internet speed your ohana needs. Act now to get a free speed upgrade to 100 megs and your first month free. Call 643-3333 to get Oceanic internet for just $29.95 per month. Plus, get our exclusive 2-hour arrival window, a money-back guarantee with no contracts and no data caps. All that and more for just $29.95 per month. Welcome to Oceanic Time Warner Cable high-speed internet. Call 643-3333 today and get a free upgrade to 100 megs and your first month free when you order Oceanic internet for only $29.95 per month.
Welcome back. You see the score. It is lopsided. Hawaii up 70-46, 3:59 left to play. UC Santa Barbara has hit the skids here after halftime, shooting just 15% in this second half, 3 of 19 from the field. Meanwhile, Hawaii 48% overall for the game, 43% in the second half, but Noah Allen has put on a show, 34 points on 11 of 14 shooting, a new career high for him, and obviously the major reason that the Rainbow Warriors have put together this substantial advantage. More substitutes coming in here for UC Santa Barbara. Andrew Pickles making his second appearance of the season. 6'8 freshman from Seattle, Washington. Matt always on the floor here for Hawaii. Larry Lewis Jr. getting ready to check in. So you wonder if maybe that's Noah Allen cue that his night might be done soon. Rimo short arms that layup.
Yes, he did.
Pickles lost control of it. And then Pickles and Owies gets into a tug of war for the loose basketball. And Noah Allen leaves the game to a strong ovation from the stature of center faithful. Larry Lewis comes in, making his 16th appearance of the season. Zach Buescher also getting into the bowl game. So a Zach Buescher sighting, the lone local boy on the team out of Iolani School, making his 11th appearance of the season.
You say local bro?
It almost came out local brother.
Yeah, brother. Okay. All right.
Always open for three. Buescher gets it to go.
Sooner, I score a lot of points. I love it. Good job for Zach.
So the Iolani brother.
Oh, wait.
Gets the bucket.
You're going way too far. I guess he is from Iolani. That's true.
Yeah, what are you? Yes.
Yeah, I was going to say. Iolani. You don't speak like that at Iolani.
Always gets it ahead to Lewis. Make generalizations there, Artie.
Okay.
Daryl Matthews comes in, so we get some of the walk-ons now on the 4-4 Hawaii. Of course, Brock Steptoe, not the typical walk-on story. He's a starting point guard, but Daryl Matthews, 6'5 junior from Los Angeles, California. Played 2 years at West LA College. Played his freshman year for Chris Acker, who was the coach there. Now an assistant, of course, with Hawaii. Matthews making his fifth entry into a game this season. Tough check the offensive board. Extra pass, and Sam Walters hitting the three. So the unlikely names now getting some pretty substantial minutes down the stretch here tonight. Matthews went up to cram it, and he's going to go to the free throw line.
Wow. We haven't seen a big. That's what I'm talking about, Cano. You know, I don't know if he can really do it, but just the fact that he tried to do it makes you feel good. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's sweet. I appreciate that, young man.
And misses the free throw.
I don't care if he didn't make the dunk, man. The fact, I mean, he woke everyone in this arena up.
He had some rude intentions, and you're right. I don't know if he necessarily
was
had it in him in that sequence to throw it down, but yeah, he was looking to punch it.
I love it. I love it.
Ryan Garrett also gets in for Hawaii. Number 20, 6'4 junior, making his sixth appearance. And that's a three ball by Christian Terrell.
Poor man always gets that three ball shot in his face. You know, he's always diving at him a little late.
Here it always answering back.
Matt always said, back and
take that, Artie Wilson.
Oh, no, he's not. Hey, he's going back and deal. I appreciate it. He goes up here, he says, boom, I'm taking the body contact, I'm going to kiss it off the glass. And then he's saying, that's right, I got that.
It's become a battle of the reserves, battle of the walk-ons.
This has actually been a good ball game right here. You know, right? This is great.
Got some up and down scoring action, that's true. Minute and a half to play. Cup check behind the D, hacked by Garrett, and Garrett hit the deck hard.
Garrett shows the ability to get off the floor.
Well, he almost bounced back up.
That's what I'm saying, he got literal off the floor. That was my goodness, good help that time. He comes over and he's just completely out of control.
So Kupchak to the line. So the five-game homestand about to wrap up here for Hawaii. Coming up next, a pair of road games. They'll rematch with UC Riverside on February 2nd. It's Thursday, and then February 4th, Saturday, they'll be at CSUN. Of course, it was Leland Green's last-second three that beat the Matadors in this building just last week. Matthews! He's trying to do some highlight reel maneuvers out there. And a foul committed by Larry Lewis.
Well, Matthews is saying, I want some time.
Hawaii looking to improve to 3-4 in the Big West Conference. And again, still awaiting official word from the NCAA regarding postseason eligibility. That is something that Aron Ganot and the coaching staff have basically decided to just leave on the back burner until, if and when, they ever find out if there's going to be another ruling made or announcement by the NCAA, which apparently stands for no communication at all.
It's in the mail.
But this is a Big West Conference that was made a little bit more interesting earlier today as UC Davis beat UC Irvine to take over first place in the conference.
How about that?
CSUN got a win as well over Riverside. They're 5-3. Wild shot there by Powell. And here comes Owies. Garrett, look at this release. Drops the three!
Now he
can shoot the basketball.
Hawaii going AYSO here tonight. Everybody getting some runs. And Brian Garrett getting in the book with that last three. Now a chance for the Bulls to dribble it out. Many here at the Stan Sheriff Center to their feet, applauding the effort. A much-needed win.
Yeah.
As Hawaii finishes this five-game homestand 3-2, improving to 9-11. 3-4 in the league. The Gauchos fall to 3-16, 1-6 in the Big West Conference. 78-56, Hawaii victorious behind 34 from Noah Allen. We'll be back.